This morning, I'd like to share the topic with you, Who Touched Me, for our mutual encouragement.
今天我们要跟大家分享的主题就是谁触摸了我。
Let's turn to the scriptures, Mark chapter 5.
请我们翻开马可第五章。
Mark chapter 5, verse 24.
第24节。
Last week, we concluded with the passage about Jairus, who is a ruler of the synagogue.
昨天上礼拜我们谈到一个管会堂的人。
And he pleaded with Jesus to go home with them because his daughter is dying.
也他求耶稣跟他回到他家去，因为耶鲁他女儿快要去世了。
And we share that Jesus, the shepherd, is following after this ruler of the synagogue home.
我们就读到耶稣，他是一个牧羊人的身份，跟随这人回家。
So as Jesus was walking, if you will, with the crowd, following after the ruler of the synagogue, then suddenly something happened.
那我们就可以想象耶稣跟众群人一起行走的时候，有一件事情发生了。
Let's read this particular passage.
我们就读一下这个记载。
Verse 24.
24节。
So Jesus went with him, and a great multitude followed him and thronged him. Verse 25. 25. Now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years. Verse 26. 26. And has suffered many things from many physicians. She has spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. Verse
27. 27节。
When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. Verse
28. 28.
For she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I will be made well. Verse
29.
29. Immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. Verse 30.
30.
And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that power had gone out of him, turned around in the crowd and said, Who touched my clothes? Verse 31.
31节。
But his disciples said to him, You see the multitude thronging you, and you say, Who touched me? Verse
32. 32.
And he looked around to see her who had done this thing. Verse
33.
33. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell down before him and told him the whole truth. Verse
34. 34节。
He said to her, Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your affliction. Amen.
Amen.
How do you feel about this passage from 2,000 years ago?
你觉得这段记载2000年前写的事情，你现在有什么感触呢？
Our main character in this passage is called a woman with a flow of blood because the Bible did not mention what her real name is.
这个故事的主角叫做一个患了12年血漏的女人。
But we know that she has this affliction for 12 years already.
圣经没有告诉我们他真的名字是什么，只知道他患了十二年的病。
Today, as we live during this time of pandemic, do you feel that you are also suffering for a long time already?
因为我们现在疫情的关系，是不是你觉得你已经受难很久了呢？
Could you sympathize with this woman thatYou know, we face a problem without any solution.
是不是现在读了这个女人的故事，你会对她产生同情心呢？
Today, you know, everyone in the world, the whole world, you know, is struggling with their health or the potential of dying.
今天我们在全世界上每一个人都要面临这个危机。
Because of the lockdown, maybe we are insecure about our job and our future.
没有生病的会因为居家隔离的关系会有一些忧郁。
Or we're struggling with how to help our children attend school at home online.
家长要帮忙小孩子用网上来学习。
Or maybe that we have interpersonal conflicts because everybody is cooped up at home.
或者家人窝在一起，难免会有一些摩擦。
Or you know, we actually have financial burdens because we have lost our job.
许多因为他们失去了工作，在财力上产生了问题。
You know, even if we are financially insecure, but there are many problems that even those with money cannot solve.
就算你在财力上没有问题，或许有一些问题不是因为金钱就能够解决的。
Just like this woman who had this issue in the blood.
举着例子说，这患了十二年血漏的女人。
Some people said that when we face larger tribulations, that we need to have the right attitude and outlook in life.
当然，人家说面临危机、面临苦处的时候，要有一个比较开朗的一个看法。
But if you look at this woman, you know her affliction. Even if she has a very positive outlook, you won't be able to solve her problem.
但是对这个患十二年血漏的女人来说，再积极的一种眼光，再积极的一种态度，也不能帮她痊愈。
Because a lot of times our problem that we face is beyond our capability or our knowledge to solve.
因为有些问题不是我们的心态，不是我们的能力能够解决的。
Just like the pandemic that we're facing today.
就像我们现在面临的新冠病毒。
There's a Chinese saying that even if we wish that we could live until 100 years old, we still will have 1,000 years of problem or worries to deal with.
有一句话说，就算能够活到百年，也有千年这么多的忧郁要去面临。
And the woman in this story, she has been afflicted for 12 years already.
今天故事这女人已经面临忧郁12年了。
She has sought out many physicians. She has spent all her money, and her problem was still not solved.
说到她已经看了许多医生，花尽所有的钱，但是病势反倒更严重了。
I would like to share a testimony of a young man named Zhao, from the mountainous region of Taiwan.
先跟大家讲一个赵先生的见证。
At age 14, he felt that he has problem walking.
14岁的时候，他觉得走路有点困难。
But he was a person who always viewed things as a glass half full. He's very optimistic in life.
但是他是一个很积极的人，往往把事情看在好的那一方面。
And he felt that since he was still very young, that the problem should solve itself over time.
觉得自己还这么年轻，这小问题应该自己就会解决了。
So he waited 4 years, his knees got worse, and he waited another 2 years until he was 20, and his knees got even more worse.
等了四年，好像觉得膝盖更严重，到20岁的时候，这膝盖更痛了。
He came from a very poor family, so he did not want to spend money and go to see the doctors.
他家境不是很好，不想花钱去看医生。
But at age 20, he felt that he needed to do something.
但是在20岁的时候，他知道他要采取什么某种行动了。
Or else it could get even worse. So he went to the largest hospital in his city.
所以他到他城市里面最大的医院去看。
And he was seen by the bone specialist and an immunologist.
他去看了骨科，去看了免疫科的一些医生。
After their diagnosis, they said that he has an early onset of arthritis.
他的病况就是他有一个早期的风湿症。
And as we know, arthritis is an autoimmune disease that you know could progressively get worse.
知道风湿症其实是一种免疫系统里面的一个问题，那时间久了会更严重。
And this man Saul, he actually felt better because now he knows what his problem is.
赵先生却觉得心安，因为知道问题出在哪里。
He thought that if the doctor could identify what his problem is, then they must be able to help him solve his problem.
心想医生既然知道病况如何，肯定会有解决的方法。
So he asked the doctor, "What must I do to be healed?" And the doctor says, "Don't worry, leave it up to us."
他就问医生说要怎么去治疗他呢？医生们说别担心，我们有办法。
We have a lot of experience, but you must stay in the hospital for a while.
我们很多经验，但是你必须留在医院一段时间。
Mr. Zhao, he felt that since there is a cure, then I don't mind staying at the hospital.
赵先生觉得既然有医疗方式，那我就住院吧。
So the same day, the doctor came and put plaster, on him.
然后那一天，医生就灌了石膏。
They cast them from his feet all the way up to his chest.
从他的脚底到他的胸口。
And he was puzzled, you know, why he was cast, for the whole body. But at least the doctor, was kind enough and considerate enough to put a hole in front of him and behind him so he could go to the restroom.
他觉得为什么全身要灌石膏呢？还好啊，大便小便的地方都还可以用。
And so he was placed in this cast and he asked the doctor, "So how long do I need to stay in this cast?"
所以他被灌了石膏后问医生说，那我要留在这个情况多久呢？
And the doctor says, 1 or 2 months.
医生说一两个月吧。
Oh my, this is not what he wanted to hear. But when there's hope, then we could endure suffering.
当然不是他心里所愿意的，但是既然是一个医疗的方式，他就接受了。
He was very optimistic, and he had trust in the doctors.
他心里非常信任医生们的医术。
So he lay in the hospital for 2 months in the end.
所以他就住了两个月的医院。
So the day arrived to take the cast off, and he was overjoyed.
当要把石膏拿掉那一天到了，他非常开心。
You know, this is the day that he's going to get well and he could get on with his life.
他终于可以痊愈了，可以恢复日常的生活。
Even though I suffer much in these 2 months, but there's a light at the end of the tunnel.
虽然两个月这段日子不是很好过，但是现在有新的盼望了。
So after they took off his cast, the doctor said, "Now you could get up and walk."
当他石膏拿掉后，医生说，起来走吧。
But he said, "Doctor, I can't even move. What should I do?"
但是他却跟医生说，我动弹不了呀。
So he actually went home that he was carried home that day.
所以是有人把他扛回家去。
And he lay in his own bed at his house, and day after day, he started this journey of laying that bed for 17 years.
但是他一旦被扛回家，放在床上，他一躺就是17年。
So if we were bedridden at the age of 90, then that might not be such a great loss.
如果我们是90岁的时候才是瘫痪在床上，那还可以接受。
But he was only 20 years old when he started that journey, and the golden years of his life.
但是他是20岁，在生命当中算是精华的时候，他就躺在床上了。
Because he cannot get out of bed, he did not marry, he did not have a job, and he did not have a future.
因为他瘫痪在床上，不能结婚，不能工作，他一生也就这样子废去了。
He was already poor, but now his mother needed to take care of him, adding more burden to his family.
家里的经济本来就不是很好，现在他母亲每天还要去照顾他，所以情况更严重了。
He said that he really didn't want to live, but he didn't have the strength to, to die.
说他真的 活不下去了，但是又没有毅力去死。
So he, after he was confined in that bed for 16 years, then one day his aunt came to visit him.
当他瘫痪在床上16年之后，他一个阿姨来看他。
His aunt is a member of the True Jesus Church.
阿姨是我们教会的信徒。
She says to him, I don't know what kind of believer you are in Jesus Christ, but the church I go to, it has the Holy Spirit as well as the truth and miracles.
阿姨对他说，我不知道你是不是个基督徒，但是我去的教会呢，里面有神迹奇事。
My church is very different from the other Christian churches.
所以我的教会跟别的基督徒的教会不一样。
It's a church of salvation. It has miracles and signs.
这个教会是有完全的得救福音，也有神迹奇事随着。
Even if you have suffered a long time already, if you have the willingness to believe, you will receive God's grace.
纵然你已经患病很久，只要你有信心，神可以医治你。
And this Mr. Zhao said to himself,I'm a Christian. I'm actually a Catholic.
赵先生心想说，我相信主，我是一个天主教信徒。
And I never heard of your church, but the Catholic Church is the most numerous and largest church in the world. If the Catholic Church cannot heal me, how could your church heal me?
心想说，天主教是最正统的教会，历史悠久。你是什么教会？我没听过呀。
Sorry about that. The computer crashed, but we're back online now. Evelyn, could you turn on the volume on the computer a little bit? So to continue with this testimony,
继续讲这个见证。
So this Mr. Zhao, he was very optimistic and curious. So he asked his aunt, "What makes your church different?"
赵先生非常有兴趣，就问他阿姨说，那你的教会特殊点在哪里？
His aunt was not a preacher, but she very simply said that, well, for one, our church, we pray in tongues, and we have the Holy Spirit, and two is that we observe the Sabbath.
阿姨也不是什么传道，就很简单的说，我们教会祷告的时候有圣灵充满，而且我们遵守安息日。
So this young man, he never heard of the Sabbath, so he asked more about that.
年轻人没有听过安息日，所以就继续问下去。
And she explained that, this is a day of rest for us to worship God.And so we could physically and spiritually have a rest.
阿姨就解释说，在安息日，我们的身体跟我们的心灵可以一起歇息来敬拜神。
He never read about this in the Bible, being a Catholic, and he did not promise that he will go to his aunt's church.
身为天主教的他没有听过安息日这个事情，但是也没有答应阿姨说要去他的教会。
But he just said that, he will look into it and check with his mom.
只说那我考察看看，问我妈妈看看吧。
One day he did have that desire to go to the True Jewish Church, so he approached his mom.
有一天他心血来潮想要去真耶稣教会，就跟他妈妈说。
But his mother says, how could you go to another church? How could you go against our Catholic faith?
母亲却对他说，我们一向都是天主教徒，你怎么可以去参加别的聚会呢？
And because of that, he did not go to our church.
因为这样，那一天他就没有来教会。
But later on, his on called him and asked him, have you gone to True Jesus Church yet?
之后阿姨打电话问他说有没有去过真耶稣教会了吗？
And Mr. Zhao says, no, no, I have not. And she says, if you're willing, I could contact a local church there so they could arrange a visitation to your house.
阿姨说没关系，你如果有兴趣要来的话，我可以打电话给地方的教会，人家会帮你带你去教会。
So one of our pastors went and visited him, and before our pastor left, he asked Mr. Zhao, would you like to come to our church and listen to the truth?
所以当地的教会的传道就去访问他，讲话完问这个赵先生说，你有没有兴趣要来教会看一看呀？
He laid on his bed and says, I would like to go, but my mom would not let me.
在床上，赵先生对传道说，我想去，但是母亲不让我去。
The pastor says, that is okay. As long as you are willing, then God will make a way.
传道说，没关系，只要你心里愿意，神会开路。
So later on, the pastor was able to arrange four brothers with a van to come and pick up Mr. Zhao.
有一天，传道就派了四个兄弟开了一个车子来接他。
And then they would deliver him back to his house after the Sabbath service. And they did that for week after week.
所以他们每个礼拜就这样子来接送赵先生有一段时间。
At church, he heard so many wonderful teachings about the Holy Spirit, and he was overjoyed.
在教会，赵先生听到很多关于圣灵的教导，他心里充满了喜乐。
And this is how the local church had nurtured this young man for close to 2 years before he finally received the Holy Spirit.
地方教会就这样子牧养了这赵先生足足两年的时间，之后他得到圣灵了。
After the Holy Spirit, then he would like to be baptized.
得到圣灵之后，赵先生就想要受洗。
So that he could receive the remission of sin as according to the Bible.
他想要得到罪的赦免，能够依照圣经得救。
The local church that he attended is actually one near the sea, so they baptize on the beach.
那个地方教会刚好是在海边，所以他们就在大海施洗。
And they explained to him that, Brother Zhao, if you want to be baptized, you need to go into the nearby ocean. But, we will have brothers to carry you in and out of the water.
他们就对赵先生说，你想受洗的话，我们会派弟兄把你扛到水里再抬出来。
But he replied, The ocean waves are so strong, I cannot even move. So what if I'm washed away, then I'll probably drown and die.
赵先生回答说，这海浪蛮大的，我又不能动，如果我被飘走的话，我一定会被溺死的。
And so he began to hesitate about getting baptized.
所以他对受洗就开始产生了一些摇动。
That night, he fell asleep and he had a dream.
当天晚上睡觉时，他做了一个异梦。
In his dream, he was laying on his bed, and suddenly there was a high mountain next to him.
在梦里，他睡觉的时候，身旁有一座高山。
And a voice from above said, "Get up and start climbing."
山顶上一个声音下来说，爬上来。他就开始往上爬。
He was excited, so he climbed and climbed, and the scenery got more and more beautiful.
他很兴奋的一面爬一面看，风景越来越漂亮。
And as he got to the top, he saw that on the other side of the mountain was a cliff that drops down into the ocean.
到山顶上的时候，发现对面有个山崖，它一直就是垂到大海里。
Looking from the edge of the cliff,Looking straight down, he panicked because he was scared of that height.
从山上看下去，他心里恐惧，因为那是很高的地方。
And he remembered he cannot swim.
记得他自己又不会游泳。
But suddenly, a hand behind him pushed him and he fell down the cliff into the ocean.
但是感觉后面有一个手一推把他推下山就一直掉到海里去。
He struggled with his hand, but he's just sunk deeper and deeper.
他手脚一直动但是没办法就越沉越深。
He tried to hold his breath, but he felt that he's about to die.
他憋住了气但是觉得自己已经快死了。
He can't hold his breath any longer, so he took a big puff of breath.
他已经憋不住了，所以他只好开始试着呼吸。
Unexpectedly, when he took a gulp of breath, it was actually fresh air.
但是他吸进来的不是海水，而是新鲜的空气。
And then he floated up into the surface of the water, and then he awoke from his dream.
他既然就浮起来了，然后他就醒过来了。
He figured this is an encouragement for our Lord Jesus Christ.
他心里认识这是主耶稣给他的一个勉励。
The mountain of God is the true church.
这神的山就是真耶稣教会。
He was afraid and initially wanted to turn back, but in a dream, a hand pushed him over.
他本来有惧怕，但是在梦里有一只手就把他推过去了。
But he was able to survive, and he was able to receive a new life.
他既然能够存活，而且得着新生命。
That's how he was able to get the courage to decide to be baptized.
之后鼓起勇气就报名受洗了。
So that day, when it is his turn to be baptized, four brothers carry him into the water.
轮到他的时候，就是四个弟兄把他扛到水里。
He was not afraid of the ocean wave because he knew he will be reborn again.
海浪再大，他也不惧怕，因为他知道他将要重生。
After baptism, after he got out of the water, then the brothers was about to carry him back to the shore.
从水里上来之后，弟兄们准备要把他扛回岸上。
But he said,Let me come down and walk.
但是他对那些抬着他的人说，你让我下来自己走。
Do you know, our friends, that he was carried into the ocean, but he was able to walk by himself back out?
我们亲爱的听众，他是被扛到水里去，但是他从水里自己走出来的。
At that moment, after baptism, his bondage,of 17 years was finally over, and he was able to walk and move freely again.
因为这个洗礼的关系，他17年所患的难就这样子被解围了。
So the first message I would like to share with you this morning is that who touch Jesus is those who have hope in God.
所以今天想跟大家分享第一个信息，就是触摸耶稣的人，就是对神有盼望的人。
Maybe your problem has been with you for 1, 3, 5, or even 10 years already.
或许你有个问题，一年、三年、五、十年都不能解决。
Maybe you don't feel like praying about your problem anymore because it has been so long.
或许你已经放弃为这件事情祷告，因为这已经很久了。
But do you realize that your life could be at a turning point this very moment, you know, if you have hope in our Lord Jesus Christ?
但是你知道吗？如果你延续你的盼望，你的拯救可能今天就来到了。
In the passage of the Bible that we just read, you know, this woman was thinking to herself,How could she solve her illness?
我们在读的这个女人的故事中，她心里想要怎样才能够得着医治。
She probably heard that Jesus is going to stop by, Jesus is walking by, and she wanted to reach out to Jesus for help.
她听见耶稣的事，就想我要去向耶稣得着医治。
She probably very naively thought that if I could just touch his clothes, then I could be made well.
意思说我只摸他的衣裳就必痊愈。
Notice that both the woman and Brother Zell, they first heard of the name of Jesus Christ first before their problem solved.
我们不只是这女人的故事，或者是赵先生的故事，他们是先听见耶稣的事。
The woman probably heard that Jesus has power to cast out demons. He has power to heal people and even raise people from the death.
或许这女人已经听见说耶稣能够医病，能够赶鬼，能够使死人复活。
Dear friends, after hearing about the testimony today, if you think these are other people's story, then you cannot receive the grace of God.
亲爱的听众朋友们，你如果觉得这些故事只是别人的故事的话，那你自己就不能得着益处了。
This woman, after she heard about the story that other people told about Jesus, she had hope. If other people could be healed, then so can I.
这个女人当她听见耶稣的事之后，心里产生了盼望，说如果别人能够得医治，我也可以。
So she made other people's testimony her own, and she grabbed onto that hope.
她将别人的见证变为自己的故事，因为心里有盼望。
Let's turn to the book of Psalm, chapter 147.
看一下诗篇147篇。
Psalm 147, verse 11.
诗篇147篇第十一节。
The Lord takes pleasure in those who fear Him, in those who hope in His mercy. The God that you come to seek is the Lord. He takes pleasure in what type of people?
这里说主耶和华喜爱什么样的人呢？
Those who fear Him and those who hope in His mercy.
喜爱敬畏他和盼望他慈爱的人。
So do you have this hope in Jesus like this woman?
你心里有像这女人一样有这一份的盼望吗？
The second message I'd like to share is that who touch Jesus? It is those who seek and find Jesus Christ.
第二想跟大家分享的信息就是触摸耶稣的人是寻找他的人。
The problem is not whether our Lord Jesus Christ has the power to solve our problem. The question is, do we believe that we could receive His grace?
问题不出在耶稣是不是有能力来医治我们，问题是说我们心里有没有这份信心。
As we read this passage, did you notice where this woman came from in the story?
当你读这个故事的时候，有没有看到这女人是从哪里冒出来的？
She squeezed herself in a crowd, trying to reach out to Jesus from behind.
27节说，就从后头来砸在众人中间。
Could you relate how she must have felt?
你可以体会当时她的情况吗？
Why did she not go in front of Jesus and kneel down and beg Jesus for healing?
为什么没在耶稣面前，在大众之前跪拜，向耶稣求医治呢？
Some of us pray to God, but we might think that, you know, God is so good and so holy. Will He help me?
有些时候我们祷告的时候觉得神是这么圣洁的神，神会来管我的小问题吗？
Do I deserve His grace?
我真的配得他的恩典吗？
This woman, she suffered from a flow of blood.
这女人已经患了12年的血漏。
2,000 years ago in Jewish society, having a flow of blood is considered a very unclean disease.
在2,000年前的世界在犹太人的圈子里，能有这种疾病是一个很污秽的一个写照。
Unlike the synagogue ruler, this woman cannot come near Jesus Christ, according to the law.
之前讲到管会堂的。这女人跟那个管会堂的不一样，这女人没有资格在众人中间。
If the woman was to touch another person without their permission, she could be stoned to death.
女人自己不洁净，如果去触摸了别人，人家可以把她用石头扎死。
Now you can understand why she had to hide herself in the crowd and touch Jesus stealthily from behind.
也就因此，他是要在众人中间暗暗的触摸耶稣。
She's worse than the beggar that we read, in the Bible on the side of the road, crying out to Jesus, "Son of David, have mercy on us."
他比那个乞丐，就是在路旁喊着，大卫的子孙耶稣，对，怜悯我们吧。他比这个乞丐更可怜。
This woman is fearful of being discovered. She's fearful of being rejected and even being stoned to death.
这妇人心里有很大的恐惧，恐惧被发觉，恐惧被用石头打死。
So do we feel this unworthiness as well to come in front of Jesus to ask for his help?
我们心里是不是也同样的有这种恐惧，不敢来耶稣面前？
Dear friends, I'd like to share that in Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. Let's turn to Matthew chapter 7, verse 7.
想跟听众们分享马太福音七章第七节。
Verse 7. Ask and you will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and you will be opened to you. Verse 8.
八节。
For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds.And to him who knocks, it will be open. Jesus said, "You." Did he specify you, Christians, or you saints?
No, he did not. 这里说你们啊，就是你们信徒，你们啊，众先众圣徒。
He just said, "You." Everybody could come and seek him and find him.
这里只是说你们就是大众，只要你们祈求哈，你们就必寻见。
The last point I would like to share with you this morning is that who touched Jesus? It is those who come before God.
最后要跟大家分享的重点就是触摸耶稣的就是来到神面前的。
In Mark chapter 5, verse 30 to 33, here the latter part of the story describes in detail another incident.
在马可五章三十节之后，又讲到另外一段故事。
In verse 30, are you perplexed at Jesus' reaction when the woman touched him?
也就是耶稣的反应，你是不是觉得耶稣的反应很特殊呢？
Jesus felt that the power had gone out of him, and he turned in the midst of the crowd and asked, "Who touched me?"
耶稣觉得有能力从自己身上出去，就在众人面前问说：“谁摸了我的衣裳？”
Did the disciples who followed Jesus all this time know why Jesus asked this question?
门徒们有体会到耶稣问题的来源吗？
Of course not, because they asked Jesus, "You see the multitude and the crowd just thronging you, and you ask who touched you?"
这些门徒们其实没有了解耶稣，只是在外表上说，你看人这么多，谁当然会碰到你呀。
Let me ask you, do you think Jesus knows who touched him already?
但让我问你，耶稣知道谁触摸了他吗？
Jesus, knows what is in our hearts.
耶稣察觉我们的心。
Jesus could even walk on water.
耶稣能够在水面上行走。
He even knows how many women, how many husbands a Samaritan woman had, in her life.
他也知道那玛利亚妇人一生中有几个先生。
So if Jesus knew already who touched him, why did Jesus even ask?
耶稣既然知道是谁触摸了他，为什么还要提出这个问题呢？
It is.For the benefit of the disciples, it is for the benefit of the woman, and it's the benefit of you and I.
那是为了造就门徒，造就这血肉病的女人，也来造就你我今天。
After Jesus asked that question, how did a woman react to Jesus' outburst?
这妇女是怎么样回答耶稣所问的问题呢？
She was fearing and trembling.
这里说到妇女战战兢兢。
Why? Because without Jesus' permission, she touched Jesus with her unclean hands.
他恐惧，因为他没有耶稣的应许，就用污秽的手去触摸了耶稣。
She saw that Jesus was looking for the person who had done this terrible deed.
他心想，耶稣可能在找是谁啊，用这不洁净的手摸了他。
Maybe Jesus seeking to take back that healing from her.
是不是耶稣要把这医治医病的能力啊拿回来呢？
What she did not know is that Jesus knows her needs while she was lurking in the crowd already.
她没有想象到说耶稣其实在这妇女还在众人掺杂之间，耶稣已经知道她在哪里了。
She did not know that Jesus healed her with his power the moment that she touched him.
她也不知道耶稣是刻意的在女人触摸她衣裳的时候，在那一刻医治了他。
She did not know who Jesus is.
妇女当然也不了解耶稣是谁。
At that very moment, she could sneak away in the crowd, or she could confess in front of Jesus.
纵然耶稣问了这个问题，妇女还是有机会逃走的。
The Bible passage says that she came back, fell before Jesus, and confessed the whole truth to him.
女人没有在众人中间逃亡，她在耶稣面前诚诚实实的把一切事情告诉神。
Thank God for her great faith.
也感谢主，她的信心很坚强。
This is a moment why Jesus want to ask his question.
这也就是为什么耶稣刻意的要问这个问题。
And so Jesus gave her a reply in verse 34.
耶稣在34节这里就直接对他讲话。
He said, "Daughter, your faith has made you well." Did you don't listen?
你的信救了你。
Jesus said the word "daughter."
说到女儿。
And this is his parting gifts to the woman.
这也是他的一个回别礼。
This is also a reason why he asked, "Who touched me?"
这也是对他自己问的问题做的一个解答。
She used to be a marginalized member of the Jewish society, but now she is the daughter of the kingdom of God.
或许之前这妇人只是一个当时犹大教的一个信徒，但是现在她是神的女儿。
Many of us come to church to receive help from God.And we think that as long as God solves our problem, that is good enough for me.
我们有时候来到教会，把问题卸给神，只要神解围，我们就开心了。
But after that, Jesus is going to ask, "Who touched me?"
但是之后，神要问我们，谁触摸了我？
You know, we could look at her predicament. Was that solved? Yes, she was satisfied with her healing.
当时这妇女得着医治已经心满意足了。
But Jesus want to give us more than what our needs are.
但是耶稣要给的不只是这个医治。
He want to solve not only our present problem, but bless upon us if we are willing to come before him.
他要解决的问题大于我们跟他求的。
In Isaiah chapter 61, verse 6 and 7,
在以赛亚书六十一章第六节七节
，In verse 6 it says that we shall be named the priests of the Lord.
说人必称你们为我们神的仆役。
In verse 7 says that we shall have double the honor.
说到我们必得加倍的好处。
And our land shall be double the portion.
我们的处境，我们在境内必得加倍的产业。
And everlasting joy shall be ours.
说到永远之乐必归于你们。
This is a prophetic passage. In the Old Testament, not everybody could be a priest.
在旧约时代，不是说每一个人都能够作为祭司。
But this actually is a prophecy about the followers of Jesus Christ.
但是以赛亚书六十一章，这里是为跟随神的人所做的一个预言。
In 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9, it says that we are a royal priesthood.
在彼得前书第二章第九节说到我们是君尊的祭司。
That is to say in the New Testament, every true believer is a priest of God.
在新约时代相信耶稣的人就是他拣选的祭司。
And as priest and servant of God, we could receive the double portion of blessings.
也因为这样子在我们的境内能够得着加倍的产业。
In Zechariah chapter 9 verse 12,
在撒迦利亚书九章十二节,
it says, Return to the stronghold, you prisoners of hope. Every day I declare that I will restore double to you.
你们被囚而有指望的人要转回宝藏，今日说明我必加倍赐福给你们。
You prisoners of hope, meaning that spiritually speaking, those who are bound by sin today, but put their hope in God.
这里说到被囚而有指望，就是在现今有苦难，但是对神有信心的人。
We must return to the stronghold, meaning we must return to God, our refuge, our Jesus Christ.
都要转回宝藏，归回主名。
As we could see from this verse, not only will Jesus bless us, but he will restore double of the portion to us.
神不只要祝福我们，还要加倍的赐福。
And this is a recurring theme in the Bible. If we look at the book of Job,
就连约伯记也有讲到这个主题。
Job, if you look at Job chapter 1 versus Job chapter 42,
从约伯记一章看到四十二章这里。
In Job chapter 1, we have a very detailed description of Job's possession. And in verse 42, especially, literally 42 verse 10.
在约伯记第一章就描写了约伯在地的产业，但是在约伯记四十二章第十节有一个很有趣的写照。
And the Lord restored Job's losses when he prayed for his friends, and indeed the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. So in the end, Job received double what he has lost in chapter 1.
约伯记四十二章十节说到，当约伯为他朋友祈祷之后，神就加倍的祝福给他，他就是比在第一章所拥有的那一些产业上有了加倍的产业。
So in conclusion, this passage, we found that the woman found the solution to her issue in the blood.
回到我们之前讲这流血女人的故事，她不只是得着了医治。
But Jesus asked, who touched me?
因为耶稣问了这个问题，摸我的是谁？
So the woman truthfully came out and testified in front of the whole crowd.
这妇女没有逃跑，却在众人面前见证所发生的事。
Not only was Jesus present, but do you realize she testified to the ruler of the synagogue?
这里不只是向耶稣承认他所做的事情，他所讲的就是在这一些犹太人中的领导人中做了一个强力的见证。
Remember, this episode happened while they were walking with the crowd to the synagogue's house.
这事情呢，是他们一大群众人往耶路的家走去的路上所发生的事。
34节。As soon as Jesus said this, go in peace Jesus said, go in peace and be made whole of the plague. Verse 35, as soon as Jesus said this, then what happened?
回到这马可福音第五章三十四节，耶稣说，你的信救了你，平平安安的回去吧。之后发生了什么事呢？
Word came from Jairus' house saying that your daughter is dead.
马上的就有人从广惠堂家里来说，你的女儿死了。
Wow, this must be such a heavy blow to the ruler of synagogue.
这对耶鲁来说是一个很大的打击。
But if you look at verse 36, Jesus said, "Do not be afraid, only believe."
但是接着紧接着36节，耶稣却说，不要怕，只要信。
And this is right after the ruler of the synagogue heard the miracle, the testimony from this woman.
才在两节之前，耶鲁刚听到这患十二年血漏的妇女的见证。
And so this is the parting message I would like to leave with all of you today.
所以今天为所有的听众，我想用这个经节做互相的勉励。
The woman testified to us today, and Jesus asks us, "Do not be afraid, only believe."
就当这妇女得着医治，耶稣对我们说，不要怕，只要信。
You know, she was blessed a double the portion, and today we could have that double blessing as well.
这妇女得着加倍的祝福，今天我们同样的也配得这加倍的祝福。
Only if our dear friends, if you could continue to worship with us attend the True Jesus Church.
亲爱的听众朋友们，只要你继续的跟我们一起来敬拜神。
We are short on time, so we're going to kneel down and offer our concluding prayer to you, God.
我们时间到了，我们就直接跪下来祷告，向神祈求。
As you pray, not only remember your needs on this world.
祷告中不只是要想到自己在世上的需求。
You know, have the faith to come in front of Jesus to receive his blessing.
要鼓起勇气到神面前接受福分。
And you'll find not only your worldly problem is solved, but that you could receive this internal blessing from our Lord Jesus Christ.
知道不止在世上，我们世上所需要的神都会给予我们，在灵性上神更要加倍的祝福我们。
Let's all kneel down and pray together.
跪下来同心祷告。